put you on YouTube. Okay, good evening YouTube. Or good morning. Again, I always do that, I don't know why. Don't know what's going on. There's a MILF there. I have absolutely no agenda today. I just haven't done anything like this for a while, any vlogs or attempted vlogs. And it's a nice day, I wanted to go for a ride. So I thought I'd film it and talk shit on the way. And let's see what happens. So what has been happening? Well, I'm not going to talk about myself too much because I'm pretty fucking boring. Ronnie Corbett has just died. Fucking devastating. Is it me or does just everybody, I mean, I'm in my early 30s. Just everybody that was important to me, like famous people, just seem to be dropping dead like flies. I mean, going back to the big one for me was Rick Mayall. Anyone ever seen Young Ones on Bottom? It's like, I sort of missed Young Ones and was a bit too young for that. Strangely. But Bottom was enormous to me as a child, and obviously as soon as I saw Bottom, went back and found Young Ones, it's like, oh my god, I love this. Absolutely crazy fucker, but yeah, he died. Obviously Lemmy, I'm a bit of a rock fan. I saw Motorhead about 3 times. Every time it's awesome, just no bullshit, explosive rock and roll. No fireworks, he didn't need anything, just on stage, he barely even moved. The guy just sat there smashing the fuck out of his bass. Screaming his, I call it a voice, whatever the sound he made was, that whiskey stained husky scream that he had, which is awesome. David Bowie, had a lot of time for him as well. But yeah, it's just famous people, what's wrong with them? They seem to have lost the ability to keep breathing. But yeah, Ronnie's a recent one, and I was a big fan of his as a kid. The two Ronnies were either still on, I think they quit in 96, and I would have probably, I may remember seeing them live once. Like, you know, as a broadcast, was more likely kind of a few years later watching the repeats of the two Ronnies, and absolutely loved it. And then kind of going back as an adult, when Ronnie Barker died, I went and watched a load of episodes that I found on YouTube, or downloaded or somewhere. And you watch it it's one of them ones where there's loads of like in-jokes for adults and stuff like that, and some of them are so clever, some of the writing. I know those two didn't write all of them, I don't even think they wrote the majority, they were like, part of the writing team and the performance, but there were other designated writers for certain bits and bobs and that. But yeah, he's gone. Rest in peace. It's just who's next, you know? To be honest, if I was famous between the ages of 60 and 80, I'd consider taking out some life insurance. Either that or hiring a lawyer, because if they're not gonna die, they're gonna get arrested for some historic kiddie fiddling practices they did. Oh, what's going on? Bloody roadworks on a Sunday. I'm not even gonna make this one. There's a fucking double white, solid white line there, so I can't even cheat. Wankers. Hairy fucking wankers. Today is my day. It's all gonna go well for me. Not. Yeah. Well, it's been in the news. That I might have an opinion of. Not on all that. No, to be honest, I've been quite busy this last week. I haven't actually been keeping up to date with the news. I'm pretty anal and pretty interested in all, you know, current affairs, world stuff, and that kind of rubbish. I do sort of read the news, websites, papers, watch the news quite a lot, but I actually can't think of much. I know OJ Simpson's just something. What was he in the news for? They found a knife on the property that he lived at, that the two murders that he may or may not have committed were committed. But it's been proven it wasn't the knife that was done, the use, so that was a bit of a non-story. For anyone that's interested in crime, like true crime and just, you know, books or whatever, TV shows, the actual O.J. Simpson TV show that's on BBC, I think, yeah, it is BBC, I've watched it now, but The People vs. O.J. Simpson, I think it's fucking brilliant. I'm really, really into it, and it's quite an accurate kind of, it's a drama, it's like acting, it's not a documentary. It's got John Travolta in it and a few other quite famous people. But it's a drama that's quite closely portraying the actual events. Obviously there will be a bit of dramatic effect put in there and all that jizzle, but I mean it was quite dramatic anyway. I don't think they need to make too much shit up. One of the most famous people in America being arrested for murder and tried for it. I mean it's easy to forget this, like quite how big he was. He was one of the biggest stars in America at the time. And he's in prison now anyway, he's got a son for armed robbery and kidnap as well, I believe. And he's got 33 years in prison, so it's a bit above a muted question now. In reality, in America, 33 years, you're probably not coming out at his age. I think he's probably 60s by now. And it's not like over here where you get 33 years and you serve half of it and you're eligible for parole and all that bollocks. I mean, you probably wouldn't even get 33 years to begin with anyway in this country. And if you did, it only really means half, unless the judge, I don't know the legal term for it, but they can actually say life without parole, make that a condition of their sentence, but they don't normally do that for run-of-the-mill sentences. I think it's only if you can consider the danger to the public. I hate, you know what, I have no issue riding in the wet, and I obviously love riding in the dry, like everybody would. The one I hate is patchy. I hate patchy. I cannot relax on it. You know, I've had a few kind of rear wheel slides before. I've not come off because of it, but I've been going around corners and hit bits of wet and just had that little, you know, the little moments you get. And sort of what happens is I'll gradually start relaxing back into corners, like patchy corners, and then I'll hit another one and it'll be like, oh, for the next kind of month or two, I'll be like every day like this, like roads like this where you got a damp patch. In fact, to be honest, it's mostly dry now. I don't know what I'm fucking whinging about. Just need to make sure I don't miss it. In fact, this is it. Ooh, nearly did miss it even though I saw it. Alright, that's far enough. Round church. Mud. traffic. So yeah, living in the southeast, we're not blessed with the greatest roads in the world. There's no, you know, it's as flat as Holland around here, pretty much. The odd hill now and again. But you know, if you look hard enough, you'll find the odd half decent road. Just wish there wasn't any bloody cars on it.